Good day, students. In this clip, we're going to be going over the top five common logarithm mistakes, okay? So let's go ahead and take a look at instructions. The instructions are as follows. We have to express the following as a single logarithmic expression where possible. All right, so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to present the problem. I'm going to try and simplify it using a common mistake, and we'll try to see if you can figure out what the mistake is, and then I'll go over what the mistake is, okay? All right, let's take a look at the first one, problem number one. What if you have the following expression, log base 3 of 5x multiplied by log base 3 of 2x? So I can say to myself, since this is a product of logs, two logs with the same base, I can simply write this as log base 3 of 5x plus 2x, all right? And then that simplifies into log base 3 of 7x, okay? All right, obviously, this is the wrong answer. So do you see what the mistake is here? This is a misapplication of the product property of logarithms. The product property of logarithms are as follows. Let's go over the property here. If the argument of your logarithmic function is a product of two factors, x, y, then this can be written as the sum of the factors, okay? The log of the sum of the factors, log base b of x plus log base b of y, all right? Now, if you look at this situation, there are two separate logarithms. The arguments are not being multiplied by each other. This is a product of logarithms. Hence, you cannot apply the property here. Okay? Had it been we had something like log base 3 of 5x times 2x, then you can apply this. It becomes log base. This becomes log base 3 of 5x plus log base 3 of 2x, okay? So the arguments must be the product. That's when you can apply the product property of logarithm. And this property is not used to condense. It's basically used to expand. As you can see, this is a single logarithmic expression being written as two logarithmic expressions here, okay? So just remember the product property. The arguments must be factors, is not the product of two logarithmic expressions. So the answer here is the correct answer. What is the correct answer? Cannot be simplified. It cannot be condensed. Okay, this one cannot be condensed. All right. Okay, let's take a look at another common mistake that students make. Number two, what if you have log base 3 of 15x divided by log base 3 of 10x? Okay, so some might think, oh, you have a quotient of two logarithmic expressions here. Oh, I can write this as a difference. I can write this as log base 3 of 15x minus 10x, and that simplifies into log base 3 of 15 minus 10, 5x. Of course, this is wrong. Now, do you see what the mistake is? Let's go over the property, the quotient property of logarithms. If the argument of the logarithmic expression is the quotient of two numbers, all right, the dividend and the divisor, this can be written as the difference of the log base d dividend minus the log of the divisor. Okay, so this can be written as a log of the numerator or the dividend minus the log of the denominator or the divisor. Okay. In order to apply this property, the logarithmic argument must be a quotient. Is that the case here? The answer is absolutely not. In the numerator, this log is not a quotient. In the denominator, this log is not a quotient. This is a quotient of two logarithmic expressions. Hence, this property cannot be applied here. Okay? Had it been you had something like this, log base b of, let's say you have 15x over 10x, then you can write this as log base b of 15x minus log base b of 10x. Okay? Now, what you note here is that this property expands, it doesn't consolidate, it doesn't condense expressions. All right? So hopefully you can see how this is a misapplication of this property there. So what is the correct answer to this problem? Can it be condensed? The answer is no. Okay, so the correct answer is the expression cannot be condensed. Cannot be condensed into a single logarithmic expression. All right? So this is a common, another common mistake students make, a misapplication of the quotient property. Now let's take a look at property number three. A common mistake number three that students make. What if they have log base 2 of 3x multiplied by log base 2 of 3x? Since these two logarithmic expressions, these two logarithmic factors are identical, I can express this as log base 2 of 3x, this entire logarithmic expression raised to the second power. Okay? And I can say, oh wait, I can use the power property here and express this as 2 log base 2 of 3x. Of course, this is wrong. Can you see what the mistake is? Now, this is a misapplication of the power property of logarithms. Let's go ahead and take a look at what that property is real quick. So let's say you have log base b of x to the power. This is equal to, you bring down that power, the power times log base b of x. Okay? So if the logarithmic argument is an exponential expression, has a power, right? If the logarithmic argument has a power, you can bring down that power as the as a to become the coefficient of the logarithmic expression, okay? So it becomes a multiplier of the entire logarithmic expression. But the bottom line is, it is the argument of the logarithmic function that must have a power. All right. Now, if you take a look at this situation, what is the argument of this logarithmic expression? 3x. Does it have a power? The answer is no. What has the power? The entire logarithmic expression has a power. So you cannot apply this property here. Had it been we had log base 2 of 3x raised to the second power, then we can express this as 2 log base 2 of 3x, because 3x is the argument of the logarithmic function and it has the power attached to it. Okay, you can view 3x squared as the argument of your logarithmic expression. That's what you're taking the log of. And in this situation, 3x, the argument of your logarithmic expression, has no power, hence you cannot apply the power property here. All right? So since this is wrong, what is the correct answer? Let's write down what the correct answer is. Your correct answer is log base 2 of 3x raised to the second power. All right? We can't go further than this. This is as far as it goes. So that's that. All right, let's take a look at the next common mistake that students make with logarithms. The top five, this is number four. Let's assume you were to, the task is to condense this logarithmic expression, log base 3 of 5x plus log base 3 of 2x. And you can reason, oh wait, we're adding two logarithmic expressions, two logarithmic terms of the same base. So wait a minute, I can just simply add them. Log base 3 of 5x plus 2x. Okay, and then my final answer will be log base 3 of 7x. Now, do you see the mistake here? This is a misapplication of the product property. We've already talked about that before. Let's go ahead and write it down again. So the product property, if you have log base b of xy, that's equal to log base b of x plus log base b of y. Okay? So in this case, we're going backwards. You notice if you have the sum of two logarithms with the same base, it's the same thing as the logarithm of the product of the logarithmic arguments. Okay? So let's go ahead and go directly to what the correct answer is. I can apply that here. So this is the correct answer. So the correct answer, using this property that we have written over here, you see the arguments of the two logs with the same base that you find in the sum of, you write it as log with the same base of the product of these two arguments of your logarithmic addends, okay? So you have 5x times 2x, okay? And then this becomes log base 3 of 10x squared. All right, so this is your correct answer using the product property of logarithms. So we can put this in parentheses right here. All right, okay, now let's take a look at the last common mistake that students make when working with logarithms, specifically condensing logarithmic expressions. What if you have log base 4 of 2x minus log base 4 of x? All right, assuming my reason, oh wait, these logarithms have the same base and we're subtracting, so I can simply express this as log base 4 of 2x minus x. Oh, that simplifies into log base 4 of x. And this is wrong. Do you see what the mistake is here? This is a misapplication of the quotient property of logarithms. Okay, let's go over what the property is real quick. So the property is, if you have the quotient of two terms as your logarithmic argument, so you're taking the log of the quotient of two terms, that can be written as the log base b of the numerator minus log base b of the denominator, the dividend minus the logarithm of the dividend minus the logarithm of the divisor using the same base. Okay, in this situation, we're going from the expanded form into the condensed form. Do you see the misapplication here? Let's go ahead and correct the common mistake. So correct answer. Correct answer is as follows. What you do is you're gonna take log base 4, the two common logs they have, the minuend of the difference of the two logarithmic functions, you take that argument there, that's going to be your numerator, okay? And then your subtrahend, the argument of your logarithmic subtrahend will be your denominator, like that, okay? So the first logarithmic argument goes on top, and then the second logarithmic argument, the one with the minus in front, goes on the bottom, okay? So just as you have x right here, x here as the first logarithmic term in the difference goes as a numerator, and then the y goes in a denominator. That's exactly what we're doing here, okay? And then that simplifies into log base 4. You can divide out the x's of 2, and then you can express this as log base 4 of 4 to the 1/2 power. And then these two cancel out, and your final answer is 1/2. All right, so there goes the top 5 common mistakes that students make when they're working with logarithms. So thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. Feel free to Subscribe to our channel for updates to other tutorials such as this. If you have any questions or comments, post it in the comments section. More clips can be found on mycoserve.com. Thanks again for watching and have a wonderful day.